They don't know much about Frank Sinatra or Franklin Delano Roosevelt, so you have to, I have to keep saying, is Chance the Rapper coming this week, or is it Taylor Swift? So I do have to ask those kind of questions to be relevant.
In the SuperAging study, what we're looking at is rate of atrophy over time, or brain shrinkage over time. And what we see is that in the SuperAgers compared to average agers, there is twice the rate of atrophy in the average agers compared to the SuperAgers.
I wish we could say that there was a trend so, you know, everybody did eat blueberries or everybody did exercise every day. But from what I've been privy to, it's really diverse. So there was one lady, I think Emily always says it this way, there's one lady who has a cocktail every day at 5 o'clock and, you know, another who has never drank her whole life. But if you ask them, you know, how did they get to be 80 and doing so well, they will tell you without a doubt that it's because they either never drank or because they had their cocktail every day. So our SuperAgers come back to see us every 18 to 24 months. And at each visit, they do some neuropsychological testing, which are paper and pencil thinking and memory type of tests. And they also get an MRI scan of their brain.
And this allows us to get kind of a proxy measure of the health of the brain. And the way that we do this is we can look at the thickness of the outer layer of the brain. We call that the cortex. It's kind of like a bark in a tree. And when we initially looked at the SuperAgers, we found that the outer layer of the brain was just as thick as individuals in their 50s and 60s.
Often when people are thinking about aging research, they're looking at what goes wrong. So people who develop memory problems or something like that. And this research really takes a look at what's going right for people who are able to maintain really good cognitive abilities as they get older. And so being a part of that is pretty fun.
And it's over at 10:30.
SuperAgers kind of have it all, right? So they're living long and they're living well. This is the type of expectation that we want to set moving forward, is that it's possible to live long and live well, and we need to identify some of those critical factors to help people live longer and better.
It's great that I'm a SuperAger. It isn't something that I trained for or went to school for. It just happened.
I think Don's not an anomaly. He's a great representative of the truly amazing people that I've gotten to meet while working in this study, and who's curious and creative and giving. And I think that's a theme that we often see in our SuperAgers, is that they tend to be active in their communities. And they're giving of themselves just to participate in this study, but that's not where their giving ends. And I think there's something to be learned from Don and the others in the study. And I'm delighted to have the opportunity to interact with them.